It's another edition of the Wrap-Up Show with John Schaefer and Jim Russell. We're presented by Mark Nimitz at Farmers Insurance. Before we get going today, if you are a Padres fan, you need to subscribe to our channel because we have year-round exclusive Padres content. Look at Jim, hit that button, hit the notification bell. So if you're a Padres fan looking for more exclusive content, please subscribe to this channel, like this video, and follow us on Twitter at John Schaefer, at Jim Russell SD. Before we get to today's theme, is Mike Clevinger the key to the Padres 2022 season? Let's tell you about Mark Nimitz, our title sponsor, because if you need auto, home, renters, or life insurance, and you're here in San Diego, then turn to a San Diegan, Mark Nimitz at Farmers Insurance. And if you own an electric vehicle, Mark has lowered his rates on select electric vehicle models, putting money right back in your wallet. He's got a decade of experience helping people like us. He's got great customer service. If you are a fan of this channel and want to support this channel and have insurance needs, click the link down below. It's in the description. You'll get to Mark's website. He can help you and your family with your insurance needs.
Yeah, guys, you know the deal. All his information is above my head. Phone number and email address, mnimitz@farmersagent.com. When you reach out to him, of course, tell him that John and Jim from the Wrap-Up Show sent you.
Mike Clevinger, could he be the key to the Padres 2022 season? We've spent so much time talking about Yu Darvish and Blake Snell and Joe Musgrove, where the fact of the matter is you're going to have a Mike Clevinger about 18 months off Tommy John surgery, who at one point about 2 years ago was an ace in the big leagues. Have we forgotten to some extent about the impact of Mike Clevinger? It's interesting because Ruben Niebla, the new Padres pitching coach, actually talked to MLB Network Radio specifically about Clevinger. And Jim, this is what he had to say.
Mike looks great right now. He's been off the mound a few times already. I've actually been there for a couple of his bullpens. His intensity level, it's really tough to slow Mike down and to bring down that intensity level. I mean, you give him an 80% marker and he's out there throwing 92 miles an hour. So I told him last time, I go, Mike, if this is your 80%, you're gonna end up throwing 100. He goes, what's wrong with that? And I go, okay, good point. But you know, he looks great. He's probably as strong as I've seen him. He's actually moving pretty well off the mound right now. And, you know, everything seems to be going well in the off season for him. He's in a pretty good mindset and he's excited. He's ready to go. And we're excited to get a healthy Mike Clevinger out there and competing every fifth day. He should be ready for spring training and have a normal spring training and start the season with us. So we're really excited. And this is a guy that's a good team and clubhouse guy. So that's another element that he brings to the table that we're excited about.
What do you think, Jim? Here's a guy with a career 3.19 ERA, 105 games, 92 starts. The Padres hope to get him. And you heard from Ruben Niebla, healthy, fully healthy for spring training 2022.
We've been talking about they need more pitching. They need guys that are reliable. Maybe some more veteran guys, because as constructed right now, it's kind of thin, just with the guys that are coming back off of injury. But I've been a little hesitant on Mike Clevinger as far as what this team can expect from him next year, just because coming off his second Tommy John, I just go back to reading his quotes and what he said after he got his first Tommy John, that it took him multiple years to figure out his mechanics again and his windup, and that it was pretty difficult to get to where he is an ace, was an ace, you know, a guy that gets you in the ERAs and the twos, double-digit win guy, 200-plus strikeout guy,
yeah,
throws 99. It took a while to get there. But I will say, on the positive side, from hearing from Ruben Niebla there, if Mike Clevinger is fully back, he can push 150, 160 innings. I mean, Corbin Burns this year only pitched 167 innings, and he won the Cy Young. So if he can give you 160 innings this year, and I think that's a lot coming off a second Tommy John, I will say that. But if he can, oh my God, that's a massive boost for this team. That could be the piece that Preller this team goes out and so-called gets this offseason, mm-hmm. right? Because Clevinger is an addition. He wasn't with the team last year. This team needs help in starting pitching. Oh, guess what? We have Mike Clevinger on the way. That is an addition to this rotation. And if you're adding a guy that is the Mike Clevinger that he was in Cleveland when Ruben Niebla was working with him, that is a massive boost. You have Clevinger, you'll have Musgrove, you'll have Snell, and hopefully a fully healthy Yu Darvish. Okay, that's a pretty good 1-4. And then you can figure out whoever your fifth starter is going to be, if it's going to be Paddock, if it's going to be, I don't know, LeMay, Weathers, it's going to be whoever else they have
at some point.
Exactly. So, hey, if Clevinger's healthy, that is a massive boost.
Well, look at it this way, 100%. And I feel like I've been very high on Mike Clevinger because I've seen how guys can bounce back in this day and age from Tommy John. I know it's the second Tommy John. I understand it. And there's risk associated with the injury. Assuming health, and I think we need to do that because, A, they're not really even pushing it because he had the surgery in October of last year. So come April, he's 18 months removed. And come the second half of the year, you're pushing 2 years removed from Tommy John surgery. And you're potentially adding, Jim, as we take a look at some of the work that Mike Clevinger's been doing already this offseason, you're potentially adding a guy that has finished top 10 in WAR for pitchers in both 2018 and 2019. That's how good he was. I'm talking about a top 10 WAR pitcher when healthy. Now, I don't think he's, to your point, I don't think we're going to get the full 180 innings. If you get 150 innings, you are golden. If he pitches to us, you know, a 3.5, even a 4 ERA, and he wins 12 games for you or 14 games for you, that is a huge addition to your staff. And I think he's fully capable. I really do of that. I mean, the only concern is really going to be the status of his arm. But again, you can't look at it like that. I mean, that's a concern with every single pitcher heading into a year. And it's not like he's the only guy coming off Tommy John surgery. The Padres have a handful of these guys. Yes, it's the second surgery, but the first one was forever ago. You know he wants to contribute. I heard him say at some point this offseason that not only does he want to contribute, he wants no restriction second half, none whatsoever. I can envision a year like Blake Snell's, Jim, where in the first half you're throwing 75 to 90 pitches and fans are frustrated. Maybe even Mike Clevinger's frustrated. But if in the second half you take the reins off and he's able to pitch 100 to 115 pitches every time out, and he can help you potentially in the postseason as well. And to your point, if he's your four, now that's again assuming health from everyone, but if he's your number four starter, wow, what an upgrade from 2021.
And the difference there between Blake Snell and Mike Clevinger potentially upcoming this year, Blake Snell was not effective in his 4 or 5 innings that he pitched the first 3.5 months of the year. Mm-hmm. If Clevinger can be effective in 4, 4 and 2/3, 4 and 1/3, 5 and 1/3 innings, like that's the key, is can he be effective in those short bursts that you're going to get from him at the start of the year and then build his way back up to where, like you said, he doesn't want to have any restrictions in the second half. Just let him go. And we never really got to see what Mike Clevinger truly is when he got traded over here to the Padres in 2020. Mm-hmm. I think we got like one start, and that was against the Giants,
where he pitched
a shutout. But now, albeit it was only a 7-inning game because
I think you're right.
I forget it was a doubleheader or something.
Doubleheader restrictions,
yeah. But still, that start, I remember that start. It was on a Sunday, and everyone was just like, oh, okay, this is the guy that they got, because his first couple starts, they up and down. You know, he didn't pitch for I want to say like a month because of the COVID issue with Cleveland, and so his first couple starts were like okay, but mm-hmm. then that start you really saw what Mike Clevinger could be, and that is a bona fide number one or number two. And probably more on the number two side, but he has the number one stuff, can throw 100, has a nasty slider, changeup, curveball. Like, he has a lot of pitches and he has ace like stuff. It's just,
he does.
Can he get those mechanics back? Can he, have his endurance back to where he's only where he's not pitching only like three or four or five innings, where he can have no limits. He can go six, seven, eight potentially. That would be huge. I don't know what other word to say. Like, it's huge, massive, big, like all the above. If you can get that Mike Clevinger next year, and I feel like some people are kind of forgetting about him a little bit just because they haven't seen him in so long. And you're like, oh, by the way, there we have Mike Clevinger on the team. I know a lot of people aren't forgetting about him, and like, dude, you guys talk about Mike Clevinger. Talk about Mike Clevinger. Well, hearing from Ruben Niebla, seeing his videos that he's posted online about, you know, him throwing off the mound. That could be the acquisition that the Padres make this year without making one because he's already on the team.
Okay, a couple of things. First of all, I do think they add a veteran starter as well. I don't think they add that, you know, multi-year $20 million a year guy. I do think they add one or two veteran starters at between, you know, $8 and $15 million per year because I think they need to. Mm-hmm. Here's the thing about Clevinger as well. He's not even 31. He's only got 500 big league innings, just over. So theoretically, he's got tons in the tank if his arm is able to hold up. Now, maybe the 150 to 160 innings is too much to expect. He's only thrown more than 126 innings one time. An amazing year in 2018 where he threw 200 innings on the nose. For Cleveland, he made 32 starts. He was 13-8 with a 3.02 ERA. So other than that, he's had 2 years where he's thrown 126 innings and 121 and two-third innings. So even if he's that guy, even if he throws 125 innings, I'm trying to do the math on that. That's 25 starts at five innings. So let's say his first 10 starts are 4 to 5 inning starts, and let's say his last 15 are 5 or 6 or 7 inning starts, and he gets to 125 to 135. We'd all take that. That's what we wanted from Dinelson Lamet this past year. Mm-hmm. You know, that's kind of what the Padres were missing. If they would have gotten 125 good innings from Dinelson Lamet, then you wouldn't have had to sign Vince Velasquez and right. Jake Arrieta, potentially, when your season was on the line. So if you get those 125, and maybe it's an if. I think it's different than Lamet, though, because he had the issue dealt with surgically.
Right.
And by and large, in today's baseball, with this Tommy John procedure, even a second time around, even if it's successful 90% of the time, you like your chances. And Dinelson Lamet obviously was not 90% healthy this past year. I would have preferred he just missed 2021 to be ready to go in 2022. So we don't know about Lamet, but I do feel confident. We don't know about health. I have no clue. Anyone could get hurt on any given pitch. But if we can assume health, I think there's a reason to believe 18 months off Tommy John surgery that he's going to be productive for the Padres. And if Blake Snell can be the pitcher he was in the second half, if Yu Darvish can just stay healthier, he doesn't have to be the first half pitcher. He's just got to be better than the second half pitcher. And then there's the Joe Musgrove situation where I'm extending him
right.
as quickly as possible this offseason as well. But regardless, in 2022, you got that four. Jim, I think we both agree you got to sign another veteran pitcher. I don't think I'm relying solely on Ryan Weathers and Mackenzie Gore and whomever else. Who'd you say earlier other than Weathers? Oh, Chris Paddock. I mean, I don't think it's a bad spot to be with the number five, but I feel like I need a five, a six, a seven, and an eight heading into the 2022 season.
Well, you need guys to eat innings. You can't go through a first half like you did last year where the bullpen was completely taxed and it ended up biting you in the ass in the second half of the year, even though they didn't want to admit it. Guess what, guys? You guys pitched the most innings of any bullpen in like the history of baseball. And it showed in the second half. Everybody was dog tired. No one was good. It's just everyone was overused. So you need to have guys from your starters give you innings. They need to eat up innings. And if that's a combination of, like you said, Paddock, Weathers, who knows? I don't know when Morhone's going to get back.
Second half is my guess, right? He had the surgery in year.
Yeah, probably closer to the second half. Lamet, wherever they're going to put him. Like they Gore, if he's still around. Like they need guys to eat up innings. So I agree with you. Getting a veteran guy who can eat you innings, right? Give you innings. You know, that's probably the last piece that Preller needs to go out and get for this rotation. And it's probably not going to cost a lot because Clevinger's not making any money this year.
No, he's really not.
Because of his surgery, I think he signed a 2-year, $11 million deal.
Yep. So it's basically a 1-year, $11 million deal, right? Because he didn't pitch. Right.
Exactly. So, the pitching, albeit there's a lot of ifs with them. If they stay healthy, that's a pretty good a pitching staff 1 through 4. And then you can worry about your fifth starter when fifth starter day comes up. You know, it's not that, it's not the most important thing in the world. You have the potential aces on your team. You have the potential inning eaters. You have the 1 through 4 set, locked, loaded, ready to go. It's about rounding out the rotation. And I think, you know, getting a guy on a 1-year deal wouldn't be the hardest thing in the world.
And by the way, I would expect that that pitcher that they sign, first of all, I'd be surprised if they sign a starter that's a multiple year guy. But if they do sign a guy that's a multiple year guy, Jim, I'd be surprised if he was a qualifying offer guy, because I don't see the Padres also giving up compensation.
No.
Because they've relied heavily on those early picks, obviously.
Yeah.
So some of these guys that aren't eligible for qualifying offers, Marcus Stroman comes to mind. Now, the problem with Stroman is, again, he's a multi-year guy because he's a
$100 million guy. Age.
Yeah, exactly. So that's so, but if you can find a guy, maybe there's a 2-year guy that's ineligible for a qualifying offer that you could get, 2 years, 20, mm-hmm. 1 year, 10. I would think they'd be in that ballpark. And by the way, I think the qualifying offer penalties are more significant for a team over the luxury tax threshold, which right. the Padres are, which is another reason to believe they're not going to be in on some of these big ticket free agent arms. With that being said, look at what the Giants did last year. And they were able to strike it big on 1-year veteran pitchers mm-hmm. that now have an opportunity to earn more. But you got to go find some pitchers like the Giants did a year ago. And I say pitchers, I don't think you need 4.
No.
It might be as simple as finding 1. Maybe it's 2, but go find that right piece in a 1 or 2 year deal, and I think you've really rounded out this rotation.
Yeah, the name that comes to mind just off the top of my head, and we've talked about it, is Corey Kluber. We mentioned him a bunch of times.
I like that.
A guy that would be on the cheap. I think he pitched 86 innings last year, I want to say.
Mm-hmm. For the Yankees?
For the Yankees. And he got injured, but he had an ERA, like a 3.86 ERA. Reunite him with Ruben Niebla. If they can get another guy that can give 86 innings out of the starter spot next year, along with all the other guys that we mentioned for the fifth starter spot, like that's what they need. They don't need a guy that has to give you 175 innings. Like, get a guy that can give it 80 to 90 innings, and you have other guys that can give you 60 to 70 innings, 80 innings. Like, that's the route to go if you want to go that route. And it's hard to expect to sign a fifth starter that's going to give you 175 innings.
Mm-hmm. By the way, real quick, you saw that the Marlins are in agreement on an extension with Sandy Alcantara, or Alcantara, however you pronounce it, mm-hmm. Which is going to be something like 5 years, $55 million. That might be a decent starting point for Joe Musgrove, which, by the way, I think is very affordable. I don't think that's doing Joe Musgrove any favors if the deal is a 5-year, $55 million deal, which is $11 million annual average valuation. I think Musgrove probably gets more than that, something like 4 years and 60. If I was, I'm making it up, I'm guessing 3 years, 50, something like that. But, you know, it's interesting to see that, you know, you got to, Alcantara is 26 years of age. And to get 5 years, 55 to stay with Miami, obviously Musgrove is an older pitcher. He's probably had more big league success. He's coming off a really good season, but, you know, this window's now, we keep talking about that. And Joe Musgrove's got to be a part of it more than just 2022. So I don't know if it's going to be, you know, this 5-year deal. I don't know if they're getting a hometown discount. I don't think they are. I think he's absolutely interested in signing an extension, but I just don't think it's going to come at a discount. But, you know, hearing an Alcantara deal, 5 years, 55, that doesn't really scare me. I think that encourages me for the possibility that AJ Preller could get a deal done with Joe Musgrove this offseason.
Yeah, that's a huge priority. Get the deal done.
Well said. All right, let's wrap this thing up. As always, we remind you, subscribe to the Wrap-Up Show. Make sure to do so. Hit that button down below. Subscribe. Hit the notification bell. We have exclusive year-round Padres content. Also, like these videos and follow us on Twitter at John Schaefer, at Jim Russell SD. We want to hear from you in the comments down below. Is Mike Clevinger someone you're counting on in 2022? Until next time, this has been the Wrap-Up Show, presented by Mark Nimitz at Farmers Insurance.